making his amateur debut. 160-pound catch weight fight. Fighting out of Katy, Texas is Nathan Harris. The nickname, The Great. I like it.
I love that.
Call your shot, baby. First fight ever, nicknamed The Great.
I like the Nate the Great, and the other all-time is Nasty Nate.
Nasty Nate.
I love seeing those.
Alliteration's huge. You got to have some alliteration. So not much on Nathan Harris other than his debut, but can tell you Nathan Harris, 6'1", came in at 156 pounds, so that's good, you know, being right there at the weight limit. If he ever does want to fight at lightweight, which I'm sure that is in the cards, you pick 160 as a catch weight. The 27-year-old.
Right there where he needs to be at that 156, yeah. 156-pound weight limit for his division.
All right, let's meet his opponent.
Please welcome to the red corner, Jaden McKinnon. Next, she wrote,
Jaden McKinnon. How cool is this? You see Alex Morono walking out, bottom right of your screen. So for Jaden, his first experience in MMA, Cody, was not coming to a Fury fight, which is awesome. It was not watching the UFC on TV. His first true in-person professional experience was cornering Alex Morono at his UFC fight.
How incredible, you know, to just get thrown in there like that. Absolutely beneficial to him to get that experience, to see it up close and personal at the biggest possible stage. And now here he is making his way into the cage here. Got his coach behind him, ready to go to battle with him. Excited to see this young man go to work.
And now he makes his debut here at Fury, which is even better. You see him, like, to make your debut at other promotions, it's cool. Like, you're still making a debut. But at Fury, you see how professional it is here, how beautiful it looks. This is a real setup.
Yeah, this for amateurs, this is probably one of the best, highest-level production setups that you can get. You got the fire, the smoke, the lights, everything. Professional level.
All right, let's get our official introductions. Here is Wayne Leggett.
Ladies and gentlemen, your next match brought to you by Live Oak Texas Vodka is scheduled for 3 rounds in the Fury Amateur Series Lightweight Division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing FSMMA, this mixed martial artist at 6'1" tall, and he weighed in at 156 pounds. Fighting out of Katy, Texas, today he makes his amateur debut. Here is Nathan Harris! And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, representing Gracie Baja in the Woodlands, Texas, this mixed martial artist is 6 feet tall, and he weighed in at 159.6 pounds. Fighting out of Houston, Texas, today he too makes his amateur debut. This is Jaden McKinnon! Your referee in charge, Patrick Petlon.
All right, Jaden, the southpaw, just turned 18, by the way. Man, it is awesome to see all these young fighters get in, get that experience. Good glove touch there. Blue gloves for Harris, red for McKinnon. Ooh, instant flurry there from Harris.
Ooh, heavy leg kick to the... Oh, got to get them fingers out of the cage, though. Referee sees it just as he gets the big lift. Jaden looking to work himself into a top half, and he does so. Good position for him to settle into here. But Harris, man, doing a great job. Trying to get back to his feet.
Again, this goes back to, remember, our first fight of the night, Laz. Young fighter is just getting into a comfortable position where
Absolutely.
You can catch your breath for a second.
Ooh, triangle opportunity here. Yeah, you want to settle into something that's comfortable for sure. Looks like we're going to get a closed guard scenario now. As it looks like McKinnon was settling for a moment, but we're back to the feet. Striking once more.
Big right from Harris just misses on the get up.
McKinnon looking to get his hands together once more, does so. Looking to get the dump again. This time a little bit further in space and into the full mount. Very great position for him to fall into here. You can see Harris trying to hold on. But McKinnon doing a great job here, controlling the position, landing some little pot shots to get him to move. Gives the backup.
Is this going to be enough for the 18-year-old working that position, trying to apply some pressure, finding some kind of opening? Now we're in a little hand play. Good defense there from Harris. Ooh, big punches there.
The corner asking for him. Double unders. Let's try and flatten him out. Oh. Going under the chin here now for the rear naked choke. Harris defending so far.
Slipping out now is that left elbow. Can McKinnon work it back in?
Working to try to get that hand underneath the chin is McKinnon. On the back, both hooks in. Great seatbelt control. Hunting for a submission. Great spot to be. Start this fight off.
Man, good strength here from the 18-year-old, by the way, Cody.
Absolutely.
Ooh.
Really going for it now. Looking to put some stress on the choke.
Ooh, big punches there from Harris.
So we're going to be coming up to short time here. McKinnon's still going after this rear naked choke, though.
Good tuck of the chin from Harris. There might be a little room here as we get the final seconds of round one, but it looks like Harris will survive as we get to round two of a fun fight.
Yeah, good little back and forth on the feet to get started, but once it got to the mat, McKinnon able to take over there. He got to the back, was able to dominate that position pretty well and finish that round out, rather, looking for that rear naked choke submission. See if we can get some of that replay there. Yeah, some of that exchanging on the feet. Both guys, oh, a good head kick there. Both guys willing to exchange, but yeah, McKinnon really taking over once the fight went down to the mat.
Hey, our first, that's us on the cam right there, like that. And once McKinnon got it to the ground, Cody, he employed a really good game. Just couldn't get the tap, but hey, look, yeah. Harris is strong too.
Yeah, Harris doing the right things there, defending, keeping the chin tucked. Not letting that necessary space open up to get the choke sank in. Some good defense there, but fresh new round, starting back up on the feet.
Just shows you how hard it is to get a tap. I mean, these guys have drilled this for hundreds, if not thousands of hours. That rear naked defense.
Here we go with the strength exchanges again on the feet.
Ooh, good jab keeping Harris at bay.
Yeah, McKinnon looking to be a little bit more methodical, it seems. Harris still throwing those big bombs out. McKinnon looking for this takedown again. Got his hands together, but couldn't quite get the lift. Just decides to run him over instead. Gets the fight to the floor once more, and here we go. Throwing these heavy shots.
Now gets both the hooks. Back.
Going for the choke once more. Looks like this one's in, Raheel. The hand's going to come out to tap.
He's good. Thumbs up from Harris.
I'm not exactly sure what happened there. I don't know if he let go thinking he tapped, but it looked like he said he was okay. Thumbs up was what we saw. McKinnon back on the choke nonetheless.
That's where it gets kind of weird, right? When the official can't see it, ref Patrick McMahon inside can't see
it. Going for it again, though.
All right, this one looks pretty deep, but let's see if that defense again.
Yeah, Harris doing a great job on the defense here, just fighting that choke off. See if he finds his way into the top position here. He's able to do so. A little turning of the tide here in the middle of the second round.
All right, now we get a chance to see the 18-year-old play a little defense.
Yeah, see if McKinnon can get that guard. Yeah, he does so now. He gets that left leg out, recovers the guard, closes it up. See if he can start to do something here. Looked like a little attempt to grab some wrist control for a moment, potentially looking for a triangle.
as Harris keeps his head low and in the chest here. You really get a chance now to see that grown man strength of the 27-year-old Harris up against the 18-year-old who's had some really good moments so far in this fight. 40 seconds left in round two. What's probably going through McKinnon's mind right now, Cody, he's had plenty of opportunities to get that tap, just could not get it. What do you think's going through his mind?
You know, he's been in a few very dominant positions on the back there, hunting for the choke. It just comes down to the finishing mechanics, right? The small little bitty things, being a little bit more patient is the only thing that I would have going through my mind right now. Is the next time I get myself in that position, I'm going to be patient, cook him a little longer before I try to go for that submission.
Oh, now Harris.
He finds himself in a rear naked choke of his own.
5 seconds left.
Short time.
Looks to be
and he
a
makes
little,
it out.
Yeah, wow. So what started as a McKinnon round probably ends up favoring Harris the final moment.
That's a very close round. They both had the kind of dominant style position on the back of each other. Harris ending the round, which is always going to be one of those scenarios where that's kind of the last impression on the judges. So maybe it could have swayed that round into his favor. So you never know when it comes down to the scorecards just how big that round could have been right there. See some of this exchanging right here, some of the replay. This is where Harris was able to turn the tide and get on top himself toward the end of that round. And you see there is where he ends the round with a locked up rear naked choke going for it. But McKinnon able to make it out. We're going to find ourselves going into a third round, which potentially could be the determining round here.
Probably unofficially round one. I think we're both confident saying that was a McKinnon round.
Yeah, he dominated on the back the majority of that round.
Round two, as he just broke out.
He had a lot of time. Didn't do much with that time. That choke that Harris had there at the end was fairly close. Who knows, six more seconds, we don't know. But nonetheless, third round is underway here. We'll see if one of these guys can find their way back to that choke. McKinnon coming out with some heavy hands, though. A little misjudgment there from Harris. Throws the big body kick. As McKinnon catches it, he slips as well.
This is where McKinnon's been really good on the ground.
The beginnings of a triangle here. Yeah, the beginnings. He needs to keep that posture broken, grab the head, start cutting his angles, doing a couple of those things right. Locks it up a little tighter here. That posture's broken. He's pulling the head now. This could be potentially a finish.
Does Nathan Harris have it in him? Is that angle going to work out for him? Looks like there's just a little opening there, a slam to break it up.
Tried to slam his way out.
Sometimes that just goes deeper in. But now the little break for McKinnon. That's it. Hold on. No, we're good. It looked like for a second, Patrick Patlano was going to get in there and stop it because McKinnon was out, but he is okay.
Yeah.
He's still moving.
I think Harris tried to say he's out. He's out of this triangle now, that's for sure. Couple moments there. We'll have to look back at some of these moments. McKinnon fully mounted here. Oh no, Harris giving the backup. McKinnon going both hooks.
Halfway through round three, final round of this fight.
Flatten him out.
Big punches. Harris with another thumbs up quickly.
Gonna have to move though, yeah.
Both fighters exhausted inside the cage, and that is it.
That's gonna do it.
How about that poker behind win for Jaden McKinnon? What a come from behind win. It looked like that was gonna be it with the triangle. But the young 18-year-old had enough to survive, turns things around, and we take a look at our replay of round three. From the triangle to getting the back of Nathan Harris, Jaden McKinnon with the round three finish. Getting his debut win here at Fury FC. What a fight. That was awesome. flex, young man, flex. You deserve it. See Alex inside, talking to his young fighter. Nathan Harris still talking to his corner. We'll make things official here in just a second. By the way, one more fight left on our prelims broadcast. James Ramon taking on Ross Thurwalker. We'll get that going next. But first, let's make things official. Here's Wayne Leggett.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Patrick Patlon calls for a stop to the action. 1 minute, 54 seconds into the third and final round. Declaring your winner by TKO, Jaden McKenna.
Jaden McKenna, first win for the 18-year-old, first of many. What a moment. Here's Cody.
Right. I'm here with the winner, Jaden McKenna. Talk about a roller coaster of a ride, man. Crazy first round. You almost find that rear naked choke. He puts one on you at the end of the second round, and then we find the TKO in the third. How are we feeling right now, man?
I feel great. Didn't expect to do that deal. He brought it. I brought it for him.
That's right, you did. Absolutely, man. Congratulations on picking up the winner. Let's give a hand one more time, Jaden McKenna, everybody.
Jaden McKenna, Gracie Baja, the Woodlands, gets their first win of the night.